Hey everyone, I'm here to show you the components of the IR kit, give you a little demo on how to use it. This is our desiccator. It keeps our salt plates dry. We have a sample holder here. It's in two parts. I'll take a part for you. We have in here our very delicate, very expensive salt plates, sodium chloride, and then this desiccant has to stay dry, so we keep this closed at all times. Rather than placing on bench paper, we're always going to place on Kim wipes. It's usually the first one that we start with. It's a liquid. And we also have methyl salicylate, wintergreen oil, another liquid, easy. All we need is a short stem pipette. Open this up, dip it in. So we get some liquid on there. You just depress here, get one little baby drop. Set that back down. We have a little drop. Simply add the second one here, get them back together. We're gonna get the plates in the sample holder. I add my finger here so that it doesn't drop in, kind of like eases it in there. And then I'm gonna tighten this just enough so it doesn't drop. So that's it. So first we wanna get a background scan. There's definitely CO2 in the atmosphere that will interfere with your spectra. Software should already be open. There is a background button. You just click that guy after making sure it's empty in there. There's the background scan, and that'll just be deleted from your stuff. We're gonna place this guy here, just like that. Close. Simply hit the scan button. All right, cool. So this was carvone. Main things we'll be looking for, the one main thing is going to be this one right here. This is our carbonyl peak, maybe some alkene peaks as well. I'll just show you how to do it for a couple. So up here we have some options. We have the labels button. I recommend not using that button because it's just too much information. So I'm gonna click that again. Instead, I'm gonna go to this cursor button. This gives me this nice little line here so I can bring it over to that carbonyl peak. If I double click, I get a number. I can drag it over to a nice place. I can drag it over to this next little peak. Double click, those numbers overlap, so I'll just put it right there. Okay, to get rid of that cursor, you just hit cursor again, and that's how you get your spectrum. There's a printer right there. Good times.
We're gonna show cleanup here. So first of all, the pipette we used is gonna go into this glass waste box. It says use pipettes only. We have our sample still in here. Now we're gonna turn this upside down, open up those plates. I'm gonna give them a little spray with acetone. This is specifically one for IR. If you're doing this in the GC lab, there'll be two different acetones. So you just give a little squirt there, that's probably a little too much. Give a little wipey-wipey. And then your plates are good to go. Okay, so I'll get a new Kim wipe. The acetone will just evaporate, it's not a big deal. Okay, and these plates are clean. Dispose of this guy. For getting the spectrum of aspirin, it's a solid. This is why we have our spatula here. I'm going to take a very small amount. One drop of Nuzol. This is a hydrocarbon mixture. This comes out kind of fast sometimes, so you don't even have to like press it, just let a drop fall out. One drop. And then I grind this to a paste. I count to 60 as I'm doing this.
What I'm left with looks like nothing, but there is stuff on there. So we're looking for a very thin toothpaste. A lot of times it's enough to take your cool little rubber policeman, scoop off this stuff so you can actually see there is some stuff on there. Now I do a little wipe. That's actually enough sample. Okay, we don't want too much sample on there, because then we get scattering. So a lot of times we don't even need to use what's in here. I'm gonna put these on here. I twist to try and get some like even coating on there. So again, if it's too much sample, the IRAs will just be deflected. Put this in my sample holder carefully.
Ta-da! Just a quick little demo for cleaning. Spray a little acetone in there, get a fresh Kim wipe, wipe that guy out, wipe off the pestle part, wipe off the rubber policeman and the spatula. Throw away the little pieces of Kim wipe. Don't just leave them out on the counter, please. Thanks. Simply run that sample the same way you did carbone. You'll also run the SIP spectrum of methyl salicylate or wintergreen oil, clean on up. Work on your analysis, and you're done. Okay, bye.